किया खाना खाया हाथ धोया नहीं गंदे हाथ बिना ढक्कन ग्लास पानी पीता वही कीटाणु पलता वही जर्म्स तेरे हाथ धो के पीछे पड़े हाथ धोले पहले भाई बाद में ले खाना बड़े मानवेली घर में खर्चा कम क्यों करता कचरा सड़ता जाता गंदगी भी बढ़ती जाती दस बीमारी तेरे पीछे लगी बच बीमारी से नन्हे बच्चों को भी रख रख बीमारी से दूर स्वच्छ बनेगा तभी तो स्वस्थ बनेगा हाँ ये शॉट है भाई स्वच्छ बनेगा तभी तो स्वस्थ बनेगा तभी तो स्वस्थ बनेगा तभी तो स्वस्थ बनेगा इंडिया स्वच्छ बनेगा तभी तो स्वस्थ बनेगा 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 स्वच्छ बनेगा तभी तो स्वस्थ बनेगा तभी तो स्वस्थ बनेगा तभी तो स्वस्थ बनेगा इंडिया
Fantastic.
Thank you. Thanks a lot for having me.
Yo. Swasth Anthem. Thank you very much, Nezi. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Swasthagraha. And now joining us is the Chief Minister of Jharkhand, Mr. Raghubar Das. Raghubar ji, aapka NDTV mein bahut bahut swagat hai. Swachhata aur swasth samaj banane ke liye, Jharkhand ki aapki sarkar ne kya kadam uthaye?
Jahan tak hamari sarkar 2014 mein झारखंड में भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेतृत्व में एक मजबूत सरकार बनी उस समय हमारी सरकार में हमारे राज्य में 18% घर में ही ODF थे इन 5 वर्षों में हम लोग ने अभियान चलाकर जो हमारे माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी का आह्वान था देश की करोड़ों जनता को 150वीं जयंती जब राष्ट्रपिता महात्मा गांधी का हम मनाए तो एक स्वच्छ भारत उनके कदमों में थे तो आज इस 2 अक्टूबर 150 जयंती में हम स्वच्छ झारखंड आज राष्ट्रपिता महात्मा गांधी के जयंती के अवसर पे दिए इसके लिए हम लोग ने राज्य की जो हमारी महिला शक्ति है उनको रानी मिस्त्री 70,000 महिलाओं को हम लोग ने रानी मिस्त्री की ट्रेनिंग देकर ये जो इतने बड़े लक्ष्य थे उस लक्ष्य को हम लोग ने प्राप्त किया
एक छोटी सी चर्चा यहाँ पर जो हम करना चाहते हैं वो है इम्यूनाइजेशन पे जिसका जिक्र हर सरकार का हर प्रतिनिधि करता है अंबिका दिस इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट इशू इम्यूनाइजेशन इट्स द बेस फॉर क्लीनिनेस एज वेल एज हाइजीन न्यूट्रिशन एवरीथिंग
इट्स लिंक्ड टू एवरीथिंग
एक्सप्लेन इट टू अस
नो सो लाइक द गवर्नमेंट हैज सो मेनी इम्यूनाइजेशन प्रोग्राम्स एंड इन फैक्ट आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क नीरज हियर You know, there are new vaccines which have come in, whether it's the rotavirus vaccine, and this has really helped in reduction of diseases. And like we said, it's the basic, whether it's nutrition, again, because if you take the rotavirus vaccine, your diarrhea is controlled. So that again, it's linked to nutrition. So tell us about the nutrition programs.
You know, we are still losing about 5 lakh children every year, under 5. And a lot of them are because of diarrhea and pneumonia. So just by two types of vaccines, the rotavirus vaccine is one which takes care of about 60% of all diarrheal diseases. The pneumococcal vaccine is which takes care of pneumonia. I think just these two vaccines are going to see a huge impact on under 5 mortality. And we refer to morbidity. Now, morbidity actually is directly linked to nutrition, directly linked to cognitive development, overall child health. So if you're able to actually vaccinate our children. And I must say, you know, the number of vaccines that have come into the immunization program over the last 5-6 years is equivalent to all the vaccines that came into our program, you know, 20 years before that. So it's really been a huge push in the right direction. At the moment, we are sitting at about 70% immunization,
okay.
But we need to get 100%.
And for the vaccines reaching, you know, that the government, JSI is working on it. We have Dr. Sanjay Kapoor. So y'all go, what is y'all intervening and making sure that the vaccines reach to each and one? Where do you think is the challenge? What is the challenge? Where we're looking at the 30%? What Dr.
Reaching out to the people, that's a very, very important aspect.
We are working very closely with Government of India to help them introduce new vaccines to improve the routine immunization. Because hamare country mein jo routine immunization hai, 5 years or 6 years back, it was increasing at the rate of 1% per year. Overall, if you see the average, this year was 60, next year 61, 62. So the government felt that it would take 30 years for them to reach, maybe 30, 40 years, maybe to reach 100% what we want to do. So this mission Indradhanush came, and then there was another intensified mission Indradhanush came, which even the Prime Minister himself inaugurated in Gujarat, which has given a big push to the immunization program. And I'm very glad to say that now India is improving at the rate of 5 to 6% per year immunization. So it has given a real push to it. And we work very closely with the government on training of these frontline workers who go from house to house in very difficult areas. Kabhi wo naav mein jate hain, kabhi wo railway station pe polio jaise vaccine pilate hain.
Bilkul sir, jungle mein jate hain, aisi aisi jagah mein jahan na sadak hoti hai na pani hota hai.
Jahan jana bahut mushkil hai.
Chote chote gaon mein jaakar ke wo kaam karte hain.
Main abhi swagat karna chahta hu Mamta Saikia ka, aap CEO hain Bharati Foundation ki. I want to know from you that in terms of preventive health care and not purely with the intention of curing, don't you think immunization is the biggest step?
So one of our program which we started when our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji gave the clarion call to the nation, we started our sanitation program, Satya Bharti Abhiyan. Now, in that program, we gave toilets. We adopted the district of Ludhiana and we gave a toilet to every household which did not have one. We believe that this entire sanitation program that we've done, the hygienic conditions that it would create, would result in prevention of many diseases. In our schools, Bharti Foundation has Satya Bharti schools in villages of the country which are completely free for underprivileged children. You will be happy to know that we have mothers who are cooking meals for our children. And we have 40,000 children, which means we are serving 8 million meals a day, which are not only hygienic because our mother is cooking that meal in her own village, but we train them on how to cook healthy meal.
We've spoken about everything that the government is doing, what we are trying to do, whether it's maternal health, whether it's the first 1,000 days. But I think something we need to talk about, there are policies. But what about the implementation? And I would like to come to you here, Bhagyashree. So do you think there's a miss in the implementation of these policies which the government has, or as a nation what we have?
I think in India we are really fortunate that we have great policies and programs, but still we are not getting the desired outcomes. And one of the root causes we believe in plan is also gender inequality. Right. There are barriers a girl and a woman she faces at every stage of her life, and it has an implication whether it's the birth of a child, malnutrition, and as you just talked about, 30% children are not immunized, and I'm sure that most of them are girls, because that is where whatever we invest, but if we don't create that awareness at the community level, we will still not have that outcome, because girls would still be excluded. As we are transitioning from Swachh Bharat to Swasth Bharat, how do we create an India where people start choosing health, where they are aware about the choices that they have, and also moving from a campaign mode to a movement mode? Because it can't be done only by the government or by organizations like us, but the key stakeholders are communities.
Do you think women don't really they can't make the right choices? Education plays an important role, but a lot of time women don't make choices. They conceive time and again. The spacing is less between children. They have a child every year, so obviously their body is anemic. So I think somewhere are we lacking on making the informed or the correct choices?
I would actually like to say that when we say that women don't make choices, we need to find out who is giving women those options to make those choices. You know, the whole idea of empowerment that we've been talking through all the panels, girls are married so early, girls don't make choices about whom they're going to marry, girls are not able to say whether they want to have children or not, and how they would like to raise their children, and so on and so forth. Even for that matter, even educated women post-marriage are not taking up employment because they're so focused on raising their children. And India has something like only 27% of women who are in employment, and there's a big discussion about why is it despite education women don't get into employment, and therefore that's a huge area of inquiry.
So ye hygiene curriculum hai aapne sare madarson mein aap laaye hain aur bachcho ko sab cheeze sikha rahe hain, chahe wo hand washing ho aur basic cheeze, uske bare mein aap hame bata sakte hain kyunki kitne sare isme involved ho chuke hain?
Ye main se initiative nahi balki isko ibadat kahunga. Madarse aur masjidein, हमारा मानना ये था कि मस्जिदों से इमाम, इमाम अगर अपनी मस्जिद से हर जुमे की नमाज में, जुमे के सर्मन्स में इस तरह के अवेयरनेस के प्रोग्राम हम देना शुरू करेंगे तो एक बहुत बड़ा इनकलाब हमारे सामने आएगा।
बनेगा स्वस्थ इंडिया में आपका एक बार फिर से स्वागत है। अक्सर ऐसी बातें हैं जो कही जाती हैं मंचों से, वो कभी कभार मंच तक ही सीमित रह जाती हैं। मीटिंग्स में जो आइडियाज निकल के आते हैं, पॉलिसीज निकल के आती हैं, वो फाइलों तक रह जाती है। लेकिन हमारी ये मंशा है कि ऐसा ना हो, और अक्सर ऐसा देखा गया है कि जो लोग इसे ग्राउंड पर इम्प्लीमेंट करते हैं वही होते हैं असली योद्धा। तो हम आपकी मुलाकात अब कराते हैं कुछ स्वच्छ वॉरियर से। इन्होंने अच्छा काम किया है और हम चाहते हैं कि उनके इस काम को पहचाना जाए। सबसे पहले अमित शुक्ला, आद्रा डिटॉल स्कूल हाइजीन प्रोग्राम। ही इज बीन अवार्डेड फॉर इनोवेशंस इन डिलीवरिंग हाइजीन प्रैक्टिसेस इन यूपी एंड बिहार। जागरण कम्युनिटी प्रोग्राम अवार्डेड फॉर मेकिंग 400 प्लस विलेजेस एंड 56 यूएलबीज ओपन डेफिकेशन फ्री। असद उमर, आगा खान फाउंडेशन डिटॉल स्कूल हाइजीन प्रोग्राम अवार्डेड फॉर कॉन्सेप्चुलाइजिंग सोप बैंक्स। पूजा कुमारी, वर्ल्ड टॉयलेट कॉलेज कम्युनिटी प्रोग्राम अवार्डेड फॉर 100% प्लेसमेंट ऑफ मैनुअल स्कैवेंजर्स फॉर वर्ल्ड टॉयलेट कॉलेज। बीजू पांडा, रेड पांडा एंटरटेनमेंट अवार्डेड फॉर वर्क ऑन ग्राउंड कम्युनिकेशन एट कुम एंड न्यूट्रिशन प्लस मदरसा प्रोग्राम। हम उम्मीद कर रहे हैं कि भारत ODF होने वाला है। अब ODF यानी कि ओपन डेफिकेशन फ्री, तो इस बुरी आदत का असर क्या सेहत पर पड़ता है? डज इट अफेक्ट आवर हेल्थ और इज इट जस्ट समथिंग दैट वी से इट्स अनसैनिटरी, वी डोंट वांट टू सी इट?
ओपन डेफिकेशन वाज समथिंग व्हिच वी फेल्ट वाज नॉट वेरी अननेचुरल इन इंडिया। पीपल हैव बीन गोइंग फॉर ओपन डेफिकेशन फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम। When the number of people were less, we had more open lands. That was a different issue altogether. But now with the population increasing, open defecation is a huge problem. It pollutes the soil, we don't realize. Earlier when people had to, maybe several hundred years back or hundreds of years back, people used to open defecate in areas where they never went again. They never visited. So the worms that came out into the soil never entered there under their feet. Because if people walk on a soil which is contaminated by night soil, the worms enter the body through the under the feet, and they migrate to your intestine. So if you don't walk on the soil where you've open defecated, you won't have worm infestation. So it's very important that if you defecate on the open, pollute the soil, you cannot walk on it. If you walk on it, walk in and around that area, you're going to have worm infestation, which is not possible now. With the amount of people we have and people defecating on the railway tracks, it gets mingled with our soil, with our life in every possible way. Therefore, we have to, so this concept has to be given to people that open defecation gives you infection, gives you worm infestation, which leads to lots of problems in your life.
One of the big concerns now is also in terms of connecting that to your hygiene and sanitation, because the use of toilets, A, people need to get the habit of using it, how do you use it, plus this whole thing of washing your hands post and having access to water, and you started the soap banks. So if you could talk a little bit about that.
So I mean, just linked to what Dr. Indira said, I mean, hygiene is a shared responsibility. So the concept of soap banks was actually started by us in schools when we had intervened with hygiene curriculum and had, you know, the best practices that children had started imbibing. And then the whole thing was, where will the soap, then the regular supply of soap come from? So on birthdays, even in rural areas, parents sometimes want to contribute something to the school. They want to come and distribute sweets. So then the whole idea was that instead of distributing sweets, why don't you come in with a soap? And that can slowly set up a bank in the school with an assured supply of soap that the children can actually manage. So we are now currently in over 200 schools, we've set up these soap banks, and it's such a simple idea, but it's something that is taking off, that the children feel that this is something that we own, so they carry that practice even further. And when parents come to the school to actually contribute soap, they're also taking a message back home that, you know, we need to use soap, we need to wash our hands regularly. So then it becomes a shared responsibility for both the school and the community.
When we help people with hygiene practice, with behavior, what is the impact we can have? And the work that you guys have done is amazing. In this country, with Dettol, with NDTV, with all the people around the table, is amazing. I was looking at the numbers, 12.5 reduction in diarrhea, 17% increase in school attendance just because of what you're doing today. And I tell you, it's a big source of inspiration. I think it's the single best program I've seen on any type of activity that we have done and maybe that others have done as well.
We run an NGO which is actually cleaning up the oceans, to be very honest, which is not directly concerned with open defecation, but it is a part of it. You know, it is a part of it because and we teach school children what the ocean is all about. Now, we find that when we started teaching adults, they were far more receptive in the beginning, but the moment they went back home, they completely forgot. And they got so caught up in their business of whatever their businesses were, and the coping and the surviving, that what they had learned during the course with us was not a primary, function. But we found with children, they carried the message for life.
नदियों का साफ होना और साफ पानी का वहां से लोगों के घर तक पहुंचना उनके गले तक पहुंचना ये कितना अहम है और आप लोगों का जो मिशन है उसका आपने जो टारगेट सेट किया उसके बारे में थोड़ा बताएं और कैसे उसे अचीव करेंगे
नदियां स्वच्छ बनी रहे स्वस्थ बनी रहे ये न केवल प्रकृति और पर्यावरण की आवश्यकता है अपितु वह यह इस पूरे प्लैनेट की आवश्यकता भी है भारत के परिप्रेक्ष्य में यदि बात करूं तो वो समाज वो देश वो संस्कृति जिसमें जल को जगदीश माना गया नदियों को पवित्र माताओं के रूप में पूजा की गई आज दुनिया की सबसे ज्यादा कंटैमिनेटेड रिवर्स और वाटर बॉडीज हमारे देश में हैं निश्चित रूप से हम सबके लिए चिंताजनक भी है और आने वाले समय में ये बहुत बड़ी चुनौती बनकर के उभरने वाला है भारत की समस्या ये है कि भारत के पास में जितनी भी नदियां हैं केवल एक हिमालयन ग्लेशियर से आने वाली एकाध दो नदियों को छोड़कर के बाकी सब नदियां मानसून के समय में ही प्रवाहित होती हैं मानसून के समय में ही उनमें एक साथ तेजी से पानी आता है हमारी जो वाटर होल्डिंग वाटर बियरिंग कैपेसिटी कम है वो भी एक चुनौती है अविरलता को लेकर के हमने गंगा में अविरलता के लिए एक नोटिफिकेशन इश्यू किया है कि गंगा पे जितने भी हेडवर्क्स या हाइडल पावर प्रोजेक्ट बने हुए वो सब एक निश्चित अमाउंट पर वाटर हमेशा ही पानी उनको छोड़ना पड़ेगा जिसको हम डेली बेसिस पर मॉनिटर करते हैं निर्मलता और अविरलता दोनों बनी रहे इस पर हम तेजी से काम कर रहे हैं
इन टर्म्स ऑफ पोल्यूशन ऑफ द रिवर्स इन असम एक्चुअली राइट अक्रॉस द कंट्री आई मीन वी लुक एट गंगा एंड जमुना देयर इज सच आइकॉनिक रिवर्स एंड देन सच टेरिबल शेप इट्स अ शेम ऑन आवर कंट्री We spent over the last 20 years, we spent 30,000 crores and there's no improvement. What are we doing different now that will make us believe that our rivers are going to be pollution free, including in Assam?
I think first of all, Pranay ji, we must acknowledge the fact that now public awareness has increased many fold. And now steps are being taken in a big program like Namami Ganga, where there is a concerted effort from government and public to clean Ganga River. Like that way, we are doing our bit so far as Brahmaputra River is concerned. And by and large, Brahmaputra water is clean water. And I don't think that we have a major complaint of river pollution in Assam because of lack of industrialization in Assam. We do not discharge lot of industrial effluents in our river. So Assam rivers, in my view, is by and large clean in compared to the river which is going through the industrialized state of our country.